Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture on the subject steam boiler. This is lecture number 7 on the steam boiler, boiler performance part 2. We will continue with the problems. So in the previous lecture, we solved problems on the boiler performance, and here in this lecture, we solve few more problems to reinforce our understanding on the boiler performance. And example number 4, so during the boiler trial, the following data were obtained. The steam pressure is 13 bar, degree of superheat is 80 degree Celsius, temperature of feed water is 85 degree Celsius, water evaporator is 3000 kilograms per hour, coal fired is 410 kilograms per hour, ash formed is 40 kilograms per hour, percentage of combustible ash is 9.6%. Moisture in the coal is 4.5%. Calorific value of the coal is 31,000 kilojoules per kilogram. Determine the efficiency of the boiler, including the superheater, and the efficiency of the boiler and the furnace combined. So we write down the given data. So pressure is 13 bar. Degree of superheat is the temperature difference across the superheater, so T minus TS. So T is the temperature of the superheater steam, and TS is the saturation temperature, which is 80 degree Celsius. Water temperature is 85 degree Celsius. Mass of the steam formed is 3000 kilograms per hour. Mass of the fuel burnt is 410 kilograms per hour. And mass of the ash formed, MA equal to 40 kilograms per hour. Combustible ash is 9.6%, moisture in the coal is 4.5%, and calorific value of the coal is 31,000 kilojoules per kilogram. And first we calculate the enthalpy of the steam at the outlet of the superheater. So H equal to Hg plus Cp into T minus Ts. So T minus Ts is directly given. So 2785. So from the steam table at the 13 bar pressure, we have to take the Hg value. So from steam table at 13 bar pressure, Hg equal to 2785.4 plus 2.1 into 80 equal to 2953.4 kilojoules per kilogram. And the enthalpy of feed water, HF1 equal to CPW into TW, which is 4.187 into 85 equal to 355.895 kilojoules per kg. And mass of the dry coal. So we have some moisture in the coal. So mass of the dry coal equal to mass of the coal minus moisture contained in the fuel. So the 410 minus 4.5% of moisture is found in the coal. So 0.045 into 410 equal to 391.55 kilograms per hour. And the boiler efficiency including the superheater. So eta B equal to MS into H minus HF1 divided by MF into CV. So 3000 is the amount of steam produced. So H equal to enthalpy of the steam at the outlet of the superheater 2953.4 minus HF1 is the enthalpy of water at the inlet of the boiler 355.895 divided by mass of the fuel burnt. Mass of the dry coal burnt is 391.55 kilograms per hour into 31000 equal to 64.2%. So the boiler efficiency including the superheater is 64.2%. Now the boiler efficiency including the furnace. So when you combine the furnace, the actual heat produced equal to heat produced by the dry coal minus heat lost in the ash. So 391.55 into 31,000, that is the amount of heat produced by the dry coal minus heat lost in the ash. So 40 kg of ash is found in the boiler, and there is a 9.6% of unburnt fuel burnt in the ash. So 40 into 0.096 into 32,800. So the calorific value of the unburnt fuel is 32,800, which is equal to 12 into 10^6 kilojoules per hour. And boiler efficiency including the furnace. So eta B equal to again MS into H minus HF1 divided by MF into CV and the heat lost in the ash. So 3000 into 2953.4 minus 355.895 divided by heat produced equal to 391.55 into 31,000 minus the heat loss in the ash equal to 40 into 0.096 into 32,800 into 100 equal to 64.89%. So, including the boiler furnace. So, when you include the boiler furnace, so heat lost in the boiler furnace is also accounted. So, the overall efficiency is 64.89%. The next problem, it is a boiler trial. So, boiler heat balance test. So, the following observations were recorded during a boiler trial. So, mass of the feed water is 640 kilograms per hour. Feed water temperature is 50 degrees Celsius. Steam pressure is 10 bar. Fuel used is 55 kilograms per hour. Calorific value of the fuel is 44,000 kilojoules per kilogram. Temperature of the hot gases is 300 degrees Celsius. Boiler room temperature is 30 degrees Celsius. Quality of the steam at the boiler exit is 0.97. Specific heat of the gases is 1.1 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Specific heat of the steam is 2.1 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And the composition of oil. So, this is the oil boiler, oil fired boiler. Composition of oil by mass. Carbon is 85%, hydrogen is 13%, and remaining is the ash. And the flue gas analysis, report of the flue gas analysis, the percentage of CO2 is 12.5%, percentage of O2 equal to 4.5%, and percentage of nitrogen is 83%. The steam partial pressure and the exhaust gases is 0.07 bar. So, the steam partial water vapor is present in the exhaust gases. So, the partial pressure of water vapor is called as, is equal to 0.07 bar. Find the equivalent evaporation, boiler efficiency, and draw the heat balance sheet per kg of the fuel. So, we listen to the steps step by step carefully, slowly I will explain, and after completing the problem, you solve on your own, then only you will get the practice, because the boiler trial, definitely you may expect a problem in the boiler trial in the university examination. You have to follow the instructions carefully, and you have to solve the problem on your own, then only you can approach the problem confidently in the examination. So, from the steam table at the 10 bar pressure, HF, enthalpy of water equal to 762.6 kilojoules per kilogram, and HFG equal to 2013.6 kilojoules per kilogram. And enthalpy of the steam at the boiler outlet, exit of the boiler, H equal to HF plus X into HFG. So, 762.6 plus 0.97 into 2013.6 equal to 2715.79 kilojoules per kilogram. And the enthalpy of the feed water, so HF1 equal to CPW into TW. So, 4.187 into 50 equal to 209.35 kilojoules per kilogram. And the rate of evaporation, M value. So, mass of water evaporated divided by the mass of fuel used. So, MS plus MS divided by MF equal to 640 divided by 55, which is 11.63 kg per kg of the coal. And the equivalent evaporation, ME equal to M into H minus HF1 divided by 2257, which is 11.63 into 2715.79 minus 209.35 divided by 2257 equal to 12.91 kilogram per kilogram of fuel. So, this is the first part of the calculation, and we calculate the boiler efficiency. So, boiler efficiency equal to MS into H minus HF1 divided by MF into calorific value. So, 640 into 2715.79 minus 209.35 divided by 55, MF equal to 55 into 44,000 kilojoules per kilogram into 100 equal to 66.2%. So, this is the first part of the problem, calculating equivalent evaporation and boiler efficiency. And the boiler trial, heat balance sheet per kg of the fuel. And heat supplied per kg of the fuel. So, heat supplied per kg of the fuel, it is equal to the calorific value. So, 44,000 kilojoules per kilogram. And the heat used for steam generation. So, Q1 equal to M into HF. So, M it is 11.63 into 2715.79 minus 209.35 equal to 29,149.9 kilojoules per kilogram. and the percentage of heat utilized in the boiler. So percentage of heat utilized equal to Q1 by QS into 100, which is 29,149.9 divided by 44,000 equal to 66.25%. So the percentage of heat utilized for converting water into steam. And the mass of the air required per kg of the fuel. So the mass of the air required equal to N into C divided by 33 into CO plus CO2. So N is the nitrogen, percentage of nitrogen in the fuel, and C is the percentage of nitrogen in the air, and C is the percentage of carbon in the fuel, and CO, CO2 are the percentage of carbon monoxide and percentage of carbon dioxide from the flue gas analysis. And 33 is the constant. So for converting carbon into nitrogen, the amount of air required, amount of nitrogen required for complete conversion of for the amount of nitrogen air required for complete conversion of carbon into carbon dioxide. So 83 into 85 divided by 33 into, there is no CO reported in the gas analysis. So 0 plus 12.4 equal to 17.1 kg per kg of the fuel. That is the mass of the air required per kg of the fuel. And the mass of the gas formed per kg of the fuel equal to mass of the air plus mass of the carbon in the fuel. So 17.1 plus 0.85 equal to 17.95 kg per kg of the fuel. And heat carried away by the gases. So Q2 equal to mg into CpG into Tg minus Ta equal to 17.95 into 1.1 into 300 minus 30 equal to 5331.15 kilojoules per kilogram of fuel. And the percentage of heat carried away by the exhaust gases equal to Q2 by QS into 100, which is 5331.15 divided by 44,000 equal to 12.11%. And moisture formed per kg of the fuel, so which is equal to 0.13 into 9, which is equal to 1.17 kg per kg of the fuel. So why there is a 9? Moisture formed is due to the moisture present in the fuel, are due to the hydrogen present in the fuel. So 9 kg of H2O is formed per kg of H2 in the fuel. That is why you multiply by 9 here. So for every kg of hydrogen in the fuel, 9 kg of hydrogen water vapor is formed. And the heat carried away by the moisture in the fuel. So mass of the moisture into enthalpy of the moisture in the gas minus enthalpy of the moisture in the air. So mass of the moisture into superheated, enthalpy of superheated steam at the 0.07 bar minus HF. So enthalpy of water at the room temperature. So mass of the moisture equal to 1.17 into enthalpy of superheated steam at the 0.07 bar. So 2572.6 plus 2.2 into 300 minus 39.03 minus HF at room temperature 4.187 into 30. So calculating, it is 3534.7 kilojoules per kg of the fuel. And in the percentage of heat carried away by the moisture, so that is equal to Q3 by QS into 100, which is 3534.7 divided by 44,000, which is equal to 8.03%. And the heat unaccounted, Q4 equal to QS minus Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3, so 44,000 minus 29,149.9 plus 5,331.15 plus 3,534.7, so that is equal to 5,984.25 kg kilojoules per kg of the fuel. And the percentage, so Q4 by QS into 100 equal to 5,984.25 divided by 44,000 equal to 13.6%, and this is the heat balance sheet. So we have to draw this table, that is, this is called as heat balance sheet. So on the left hand side we have the heat supplied, so which is 44,000, which is considered as 100%, and how the heat is utilized. So heat utilized in the boiler for conversion of water into steam to produce the steam, 29,149.9 kilojoules per kg of the fuel, which is 66.25%. Heat carried away by the exhaust gases, 5,331.15, which is 12.11%. And heat carried away by the moisture in the fuel, 3,534.7, which is 8.03%. And heat unaccounted, which is 5,984.25, which is 13.6%. And vertically, you total, calculate the total of heat utilization, which is equal to 44,000, and the percentage is 100%. So you have to calculate and prepare the heat balance sheet for the boiler trial. And look at the video once again so that you can understand the procedure and you solve the problem on your own. Then only you will get the confidence of calculating the boiler heat balance sheet. We solve one more example on the heat balance sheet. Draw the heat balance sheet for the boiler trial data. So feed water supply is 4500 kilograms per hour at 70 degrees Celsius. Steam pressure is 10 bar. Barometer reading is 75 centimeter of mercury. Normally the barometer reading is 760 millimeter or 76 centimeter of mercury. Now it is lower than the normal value. So for finding the drainage fraction, the steam is passed through a throttling calorimeter. The pressure after throttling is 1.6 centimeter of mercury. The temperature after throttling is 105 degrees Celsius. The coal used is 400 kilograms per hour. Calorific value is 40.5 megajoules per kilogram. Moisture in the fuel is 5.2%. The coal analysis it gives carbon 89%, hydrogen 3%, volatile metal 4% and the remaining is ash, and temperature of the gas is equal to 280 degrees Celsius and the ambient temperature is 30 degrees Celsius. And the coal analysis that gives CO2 equal to 10.9%, O2 equal to 7%, carbon monoxide is equal to 1.1%, nitrogen is 81%. And the specific heat of gases is 1.005 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And the specific heat of the steam equal to 2.2 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Calorific value for conversion of CO to CO2. CO, carbon monoxide to carbon dioxide, is 23,740 kilojoules per kilogram. And the partial pressure of water vapor in gases equal to 0.0027 bar. So the pressure of the steam leaving the boiler corrected to the boiler barometering. First you have to correct. So because the barometer reads 75 centimeter of mercury, whereas the standard barometer reading is 76 centimeter of mercury. So 10 plus 75 by 76 into 1.01325 equal to 11 bar. So the boiler pressure, steam pressure at the outlet of the boiler is 11 bar. And the pressure after throttling, pressure of the steam after throttling, again, you have to correct 75 plus 1.6 divided by 76 into 1.01325 equal to 1.02 bar. To find the drainage fraction of the steam, so you have to refer to the steam table. So enthalpy for throttling, it is a throttling calorimeter. So for throttling calorimeter, enthalpy before throttling at 11 bar is equal to enthalpy after throttling at 1.02 bar. So the enthalpy before throttling is HF plus X into HFG, which is equal to, after throttling it is superheated vapor, so HG plus CP into T super minus TS, which is 781.2 plus X into 1998.5 equal to 2676 plus 2.2 into 105 minus 100.2. All these data we have to take from the steam table. So the HF and HFG for the boiler pressure 11 bar, HG and TS for the throttling pressure 1.02 bar from the steam table, and you have to take from the steam table and substitute here to calculate the X value, which is 0.95. And the heat supplied per kg of the coal, which is 40,500 kilojoules per kilogram, and the enthalpy of the steam at the boiler exit, H equal to HF plus X into HFG, so 781.2 plus 0.95 into 1998.5 equal to 2679.7 kilojoules per kilogram, and the enthalpy of the feed water HF1 equal to CPW into TW, which is 4.187 into 70 equal to 293.09 kilojoules per kilogram, and the rate of evaporation M equal to mass of water evaporated divided by mass of the fuel used, MS by MF equal to 4500 divided by 400 equal to 11.25 kilogram per kilogram of the coal. And the heat used in the steam generation, Q1 equal to M into H minus HF equal to 11.25 into 2679.7 minus 293.09 equal to 26,849.3 kilojoules per kilogram of fuel. The percentage of heat used in the boiler, so Q1 by QS into 100, so 26,849.3 divided by 40,500 into 100 equal to 66.29%. And the mass of the air required per kg of the fuel, this is equal to N by 33 into CO plus CO2 into carbon per kg of the dry coal. So, which is 81 divided by 33 into 1.1. The percentage of CO is given as 1.1 and percentage of CO2 is given as 10.9 into 89 divided by 1 minus 0.052. So, it is equal to 19.2 kilogram per kilogram of fuel. And the mass of the dry flue gas is equal to mass of the air plus mass of the dry coal. So, 19.2 into 0.89 into 1 minus 0.052. So, 5.2% of moisture is found in the coal. So, that is why 1 minus 0.052 is equal to 20 kg per kg of the fuel. And the heat carried away by the gas is equal to Q2 equal to Mg into CpG into Tg minus Ta, which is 20 into 1.005. into 280 minus 30 equal to 5025 kilojoules per kg of the fuel. And we calculate the percentage of heat carried away by the gases. So, which is Q2 by Qs into 100, which is 5025 divided by 40500 into 100 equal to 12.4%. And the mass of the moisture in the gases. So, moisture in the fuel plus mass of the moisture formed by burning H2 in the fuel. So, the fuel contains 5.2%, so 0.052 into 9 into 0.03 equal to 0.322 kg per kg of the fuel, and the heat carried out by the moisture is equal to mass of the moisture minus into enthalpy ratio of the gas. So, mass of the moisture into Hg plus Cps into 280 minus Ts minus Cpa into Ta at 0.027 bar. Again, from the steam table, we have to collect data for 0.027 bar. So, 0.322 into 2542.36 into 2.2 into 280 minus 22.26 minus 1.005 into 30 equal to 991.5 kilojoules per kilogram. And the percentage of heat carried away by the moisture equal to Q3 divided by Qs into 100, which is 991.5 divided by 40,500 into 100 equal to 2.44%. And the heat loss due to incomplete combustion. So, Q4 equal to mass of CO per kg of the dry coal into calorific value for conversion of carbon monoxide into carbon dioxide. So, the percentage of CO equal to CO divided by CO plus CO2 into carbon. That is what the equation into calorific value for conversion of CO to CO2. So, 1.1 divided by 1.1 into 10.9 into 1 minus 0.052, that is the percentage of carbon in the dry coal, into 23,740 equal to 2,063 kilojoules per kg of the fuel, and the percentage of heat loss due to the incomplete combustion, which is Q4 by Qs into 100, so 2,063 divided by 40,500 into 100 equal to 5.09%. And the heat unaccounted equal to, so Q5 equal to Qs minus Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 plus Q4, and calculating 40,500 minus 26,849.3 plus 5,025 plus 991.5 plus 2,063, that is equal to 5,571.2 kilojoules per kg of the fuel. And in percentage, so Q by Q5 by Qs into 100, so 5,571.2 divided by 40,500 equal to 13.75%. So, all the calculations are over and we have to prepare the heat balance sheet. So, the heat balance sheet for the given boiler. So, the heat supplied Qs equal to 40,500, which is considered as 100%, and the heat used in the boiler, heat utilization, heat used in the boiler 26,849.3, which is 66.29%. Heat carried away by the gases equal to 5,025, which is 12.43%. Heat carried away by the moisture in the fuel is 991.5, which is 2.44%. And heat loss into the incomplete combustion is 2063.63, which is 5.09%. And the heat unaccounted equal to 5,571.2, which is 13.75%. So, vertically, you prepare the sum, the add the heat in the kilojoules per kg of the fuel and in percentage. So, these two are balanced. So, the heat supplied is equal to heat used, that is what the heat balance sheet. So, the problem, normally when we practice the problem in the classroom, So you will be working with the calculator and calculate all the parameter. So there is no opportunity for you to practice when I am discussing the problem. So you listen to the video 2-3 times and you take the problem and solve on your own. Then only you will get the familiarity. It is my request and the appeal. If you just listening to the video will not help you to solve the problem in the examination. So you have to solve on your own using the calculator, referring to the data for the given data of the problem, referring to the scheme table and the required properties you have to remember and calculate on your own, then only you can solve problem in the examination. And these are all the books I published earlier, so you can read for your better learning. So design of transmission system, turbo machines, heat and mass transfer, operations research, gas dynamics and jet propulsion, thermal engineering, fluid mechanics and machinery. Also, I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures of all the subjects. Also, I upload the video lectures on the solution for the gate question paper. So you listen to the videos, subscribe the channel, listen to the videos for your better learning and to pass in the gate examination. So thank you for watching. So you post your comments on the comments box in the YouTube video, and you can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification. Thank you very much for watching, and we will meet again with additional problems in the boiler performance.